Hello everybody, this is an example of using logistic regression with FastAPI. So let's begin. This is probably not going to be quite structured as normal. I wanted to just run through some things which I've put together just for fun. And the first thing to look at is, if you've not come across the book, it's called Python One-Liners. I think I probably showed it before. There you go. It's published by No Starch Press. It's quite a good book. The reason I like it is because it kind of, well, it stretches you a bit. It's, yeah, it's here anyway. The GitHub repo, there's a dedicated website to it as well, so pythononeliners.com. If you're familiar with the Finkster channel, you will have come across the author, Christian Mayer. Anyway, enough of that. What I'm actually doing is using an example from that book on page 92. Begins on the actual machine learning chapter, covers, starts on chapter 4. And it starts with logistic regression, linear regression, and moves on to k-means and various other bits and pieces. So what I've got here is from sklearn.linear model import logistic regression. The whole point of logistic regression is classification. So what we want to do with this example, which I've pretty much just copied from the book, however, if you copy from the book, there's an error, and that is the error. In the book, towards the bottom of page 92, it says reshape n, comma, 1. It should be reshape minus 1, comma, 1. It's in the GitHub example. The GitHub example is correct, but the book is wrong. Obviously, the book was printed, and then they discovered the error. So what this is actually doing is it's classifying using, it's called a sigmoid curve and a sigmoid function. And what it's doing is it's predicting the chance of cancer statistically based upon the number of cigarettes that somebody smokes per day. Sorry if you can hear a noise, that's my idiot neighbor just returning with his 5-liter Mustang. Right, so this is using logistic regression. We're creating the model. The model equals logistic regression, and then it's fitting this data, but we're reshaping the data. And then there I've just checked it based on passing it 2 cigarettes per day. If we pass it 55 cigarettes per day. I'll need to run it all again. And you can see yes. And to get the cutoff point, you can do, because I thought it's likely to between 0 and 40 per day, then I put it in, and where it crosses the 50-50 line is where you get the crossover point. So if you smoke 35 a day, you should be okay. If you smoke 36 a day, you're not okay. So if we put 35 in here, no, 36, and you see it says a yes. And that's because between 35 and 36, it flips from 51 down to 45. So it shows you the chance of yes, and that's the chance of no. So add the two together and you should get one. That's the model anyway. That's the linear regression model. Sorry, linear regression. And what I've done is I've written the code to use it so that it produces an API which I can then test. So if you want to see the code, so FastAPI, I didn't cover it in the previous video, which I probably should have done, but thankfully you're here watching this one. if you type in, once you've got FastAPI running, which you can run from, if you're in VS Code, the best way to run it is start debugging, so just press F5. If you try and run it as Python code, you just get nothing. So you need to do start debugging like this. And then it will give you all this screen waiting for startup. Startup complete, UVCorn running on 127.0.1, port 8000. Once that's running, as I say, then you can go to that URL, then just type docs, D-O-C-S with a hash at the end. And you get this screen, and this is brilliant, and you can test everything within this GUI. So there we've got the request body. I'm using post requests, and my route is tabs/tabs. All will become clear in a minute. So just to test, I've actually got the API, FastAPI running. So if we do execute and scroll down, you see the risk says yes. If we do reset, if we just go to, actually, if I just go back to docs, refresh, this is the initial screen you'll get. For every time that you use post or get within your code, you'll get one of these, and each one of these endpoints will give you these options, and then there's a try and act button. So it's a lot easier than doing it with testing it in a browser or Insomnia or Postman, etc. So you could try it out. If you try it out, it lets you edit the body. If we put in 35 here, execute, and you see risk is no, which is the same as what we had when we put in 35 into, so I need to run all cells, sorry. So run all, clumsy butterfingers. What have I done there? Oh, I accidentally deleted the bracket. Sorry about that. There we go. 36 was yes. 35 here is no. 36, obviously it'll give us the same answer. There we go, yes. Right, so hopefully I've laid kind of the groundwork. I've introduced you to Python one-liners, a machine learning logistic regression example. Linear regression is where you get the straight line and then you kind of predict, make predictions based on that best fit line. Here we've got like a best fit, it's like a sigmoid curve, S-shaped curve. So that's why we're using logistic regression as opposed to linear regression. And yeah, let's look at the code. So if I can remember, Control K. As per, pretty much to start with, I pasted in the code from Jupyter Notebook example. So import NumPy as MP, from sklearn linear model import logistic regression. I can stop that now actually, can't I? App equals FastAPI, so you're instantiating FastAPI. You create, I'm also using from Pydantic import base model, which you saw me do in the previous example. That's basically for typing, so it allows you to say that sigs equals int. If they don't provide it, then you will get some good error checking. Again, all this is from the Python one-liners book with this error, remember, that was n. Don't use n as per the book, it's minus one as per the correction and the new updated GitHub code if you go to python1liners.com GitHub page, etc. Again, like the previous example, I'm just outputting a dictionary, which is the best way to do it. Right, at app.post/tabs, so you're creating an endpoint to talk to. Then we do def, and I'm just saying index. You can call it whatever you want. You can call it, I should have probably just made it match, called it tabs, to be honest. So chance equals model predict. So I've created the model, or following the one-liners code, you've got the model here, which is being made to fit the example data. What that actually returns, though, is it returns a list. If you use that, if you don't change it to a string, you will get a strange dictionary with an N and then a colon and then an O, or a Y and then a colon and then an E. So don't do that. You need to change it back to a string. Then you create the dictionary, use output risk. So risk will be what appears on the left-hand side, and then chance will be what appears on the right-hand side. So it'll say risk colon yes or risk colon no. Sorry about the flickering screen. I think I think the Nvidia drivers, did Microsoft do some deal with Nvidia, and then the Linux video drivers don't have access to the full code? I can't remember. Anyway, I digress. So then we return the output. The output is obviously what you will see on the screen, and it's what we just saw in FastAPI, aka Swagger, the GUI. So if you're ready to run this, let's just quit out of Zen mode. Control Z, K, nope, was it? Control Z, nope. Oh, escape gets you out of it. And we've got, what are these 8 problems? Sorry. Let's call that tabs. Right, let's, as I say, the best way to run it is to do F5 if you're in VS Code. That will fire up UVCOM. Then wait the mouse over that link, then follow link. And don't worry about this, detail not found, because we need to say /tabs. Then it'll say method not allowed, because we're using post. So then you say, start off with, we'll just say docs, and that'll bring us into the FastAPI Swagger UI. Let's say Swagger. And then let's test it. As you see me do this just now, so we'll just whiz through this. 44, so that should say risk equals yes. Execute, and there we go, risk equals yes. Right, so let's just test this with the old school Python and requests. So if you want to do it that way, you can do import requests, URL equals http://127.0.0.1/8000/tabs. Data, SIGS, 25, so just types all that. If we run it, the risk is no. And again, 46, and then we go, risk equals yes. So hopefully this has just given you a little bit of, I don't know, inspiration really. It's just not, I wouldn't say this is a tutorial or such. All I've done pretty much is copied the logistic regression example from Python one-liners, and what I've done is I've made it work with FastAPI, and I've tested it using Swagger and FastAPI. So really, this is just a bit of inspiration really, and just it's kind of just building upon what we saw in the last video where I created, what did I create in the last video? Forgotten already. sentiment analysis. Yeah. So this is, hope the next one could get a little bit more complicated, because as I say, so far we've just been using, the key thing here is to remember that so far we've done sentiment analysis, and now we've done logistic regression. It's called binomial because you've got potentially two outputs. You've got a yes or a no. Again, just to re-emphasize, FastAPI, well, an API is not the same as CRUD. So you don't, an API is not just to create, read, update, delete from a database. It can do many more things, as many of you will be aware of. So to be honest, I wasn't really that au fait with it up until recently, but yeah. Have a think about how you can do interesting things with FastAPI. If anybody's got any comments or suggestions, you can say, this is not really a tutorial. I just wanted to kind of showcase what you can do and kind of put a few things together. So we've put together logistic regression example from Python one-liners. We've done a quick tour of Swagger UI, which you will automatically get when you run the debugger. So again, start debugging F5 in VS Code, and that will do it for you quite nicely. And yeah, there we go. So just really a bit of a guided tour of a little mini project using FastAPI, Pedantic, sklearn, NumPy. I think I'll probably, like many of you expect, I'll probably need to go back and practice more NumPy, because the whole kind of reshape thing, and if you've not used it recently, then it kind of gets a little bit confusing with the rows and the columns and reshaping and so on. So yeah, there we go. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.